As Jesus stood on the crest of the Mount of Olives, looking down on Jerusalem, his heart was filled with anguish and pain. With a divine vision of the future, he saw the Jewish people scattered all over the world. The city in ruins, the temple in flames, destroyed and devastated. With a heart filled with sorrow, he cried out, "Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how often I would have gathered you together as a hen gathers her chicks, but you would not." John the Sieve, verse 15, says, "He came to his own, but his own did not receive him." After ministering for more than 3 years in and around Jerusalem, Jesus' time on earth was drawing to a close when he uttered his fateful declaration and warning about Jerusalem. The temple Jesus contemplated as he stood on the Mount of Olives was the second permanent structure to rise there. Originally, when the Israelites left Egypt, they traveled with a temporary tent which, even after their arrival in Israel, was erected in silos and used for 300 years. Finally, the first temple was completed during the reign of King Solomon in the year 957 BC, then destroyed by the Babylonians in 587 BC, and many objects were transported from Jerusalem to Babylon. After 70 years of captivity predicted by the prophet Jeremiah, the Israelites were able to return under the reign of the Medes and Persians led by King Cyrus. The temple was rebuilt from 538 BC following Cyrus's decree, but some local opposition delayed its comprehension until 515 BC. This temple survived for over 500 years and is the one Jesus visited where he spoke as a child, ministered as an adult, and wept before being crucified. Sometimes called Rubabel's temple because he initiated its construction, it was later renovated and enlarged in the time of King Herod. In Matthew 24 verses 15 and 16, Jesus warned his disciples to flee as soon as they saw the abomination of desolation erected in the holy place. This came true when the Roman armies, under the command of Cestius, surrounded Jerusalem in 66 AD. Although Cestius succeeded in setting up his forces outside the city walls, he failed to conquer the temple and eventually retreated, losing over 5,000 soldiers, according to Josephus's accounts. The withdrawal of the armies was a sign for God's people to flee the city, which all those who had heard Jesus' words in Matthew chapter 24 did. While the Romans fought the Jews, they fled to the city of Pella, located in present-day Jordan, on the other side of the Jordan River, thus avoiding imminent destruction. However, Cestius' initial victory strengthened Jewish resistance, only to backfire 4 years later when the Roman armies returned under Titus in AD 70. The encirclement of the city during Passover, when the streets were crowded, only heightened the impending horror. Famine, disease, and misery spread rapidly through the city. The natural love between children, parents, and grandparents disappeared as everyone fought for their own survival. Those who tried to flee the city were captured and crucified on the outer walls, filling the valleys with crosses as a warning to those inside not to try to escape. Eventually, the city was stormed, despite Titus' orders to his soldiers not to destroy the temple in his own attempts to stop it. In accordance with Jesus' prophecy, the temple was completely destroyed, leaving only stone upon stone. D. Dear friends, Jesus has also warned today's world of the coming crisis, and he has given us a glimpse of the signs of his return so that we are not left in the dark. He doesn't want anyone to get lost, and he has described exactly what will happen before he returns, so that we know exactly the signs of his return. We can rest assured that just as no true believers were killed when Jerusalem was destroyed, so today those of us who observe the signs will not be destroyed, but Jesus will protect us in the last days of this earth's history.